not often we get snowfall, so I've got to make the most of it and come out and see what images I can capture. I've got my main camera that I use for shooting the video, that's a Lumix. I've got the GoPro Hero 7, which I'm filming on at the moment. And I've also brought my old Nikon D3200, which I use for stills photography. I don't do a lot of stills, but I thought with snow, I've got to come out and capture what I can. I've left the dog behind because I took her out for a walk this morning. I don't think she's that keen on the snow. Or it could have been that, or it could have been the people playing in the park, which actually sort of scared her off. And anyway, she ran back home, didn't she? So I've left her at home.
Come on then, out you come. What is it? What's different then? What's so different? Why don't you want to come out? What is it? This is different, isn't it?
As you can see, we've had a significant fall of snow. This is my dog's first exposure, her first sight of snow, and she was a bit wary when we were coming out the front door, but she's going crazy. I think she's going to really enjoy this.
Are you ready? Come on, off you go then.
Do you want to be on video?
I don't mind, mate.
I've just met one of my subscribers who watches me. I don't know what his name is, but... How are you then?
Sally, welcome to sunny Swindon.
Amber, come on then.
Say hello for the video. Say hello.
Kind of turned into a race against time because the air temperatures rose and the snow which has settled on the twigs and the branches beginning to melt, and that's what I was here for. I wanted to try and get some of that, like this look. Got some snow melt on the glass, so yeah, it's a race against time now to get into the woods where I can get my tripod and my stills camera out and try and get some of these wintry images. When it comes to photography, I'm what's called a keen amateur. Not occasionally keen when an opportunity like this presents itself. I haven't got a very good camera for stills. I've only got an old Nikon D3200 that I've had for about 10 years. It's a very entry-level camera, so the images that I take with it, you'll be able to see what an old 10-year-old DSLR can do. I haven't got any expensive editing software, just a very basic package which comes with the camera. We'll see if we can tweak them and make them look nice. But of course, with photography, it's all down to composition and the artist's eye. I'm not an artist, of course, I'm just me, but I do appreciate a good scene. This is the old Kingsdown Lane. I've done a video on the Kingsdown Lane last year, I think. I cycled all the way along it. I'll put a link to that up in the top left hand corner if you want to go and look at it. Anyway, we're into the woods now. Let's see if we can find that magical place where I can take this stunning photograph. Well, I have managed to take some photographs. I did get here just in time. There's still snow on the branches, and I'm actually walking through a field of teasels at the moment, and managed to take a few snaps of those as well. And what I'm doing, I'm taking different exposures, so hopefully I'm going to get at least a few correctly exposed images. Yeah, the teasel field, the field of teasels. So I make my way to a lovely little piece of woodland that I know no one else comes here much. I've never spotted much sign of human activity here, so I'll get in there, I'll show you my camera, and I'll get another brew on, as I like to do when I come in, when I come out into nature. I'll get a brew on, and I'm looking around all the time for something nice to take a photograph of. Having a sit pad makes all the difference. Keeps the cold from your nether regions. It's softer to sit on, quite nice. Got a hint, important hint and tip to share with you regarding snowy weather, and that is don't drink yellow snow. I brought the Roar out with me again. This is the brew kit. Plastic cuxed style stove, some sugar, got a tea bag. I think I've got a coffee in there somewhere. There's the stove. If you saw it in my last video, I'll put a link up to that there. Oh yeah, I'll have a coffee this time, I think. Let's get a brew on the go. I find this little mug, which comes with the stove, makes it a nice compact unit, quite enough water to boil for a decent cup of tea or coffee. Perhaps two of them you'd need for a rehydrated meal. This equalises the pressure in the stove. This time I'm gonna, I know there's a way you can prime these stoves by using your hand. Cup your hand, open the valve, cup your hand around the reservoir. This warms the reservoir, causes the fuel inside to expand, and makes it come out and prime. But by the time I've done this, not only am I getting cold hands, also I'm wasting 30 or 40 seconds and there's still no fuel coming out of the thing. So I'm not going to do that. It's cold weather, I don't want cold hands. I'm priming it the way I always prime it. The little pan itself's got a little where you can hold it like that,
these pot supports swiveling in and out. I think in cold weather they recommend that you insulate the base from the ground, but as you can see it's getting going, and it would go a bit harder if I was to have the reservoir insulated from the ground. Anyway, let's get a boil on. There's no yellow water in there. Having a Svea123r means you will definitely appreciate the sound of silence a lot more. It is a noisy stove. I quite like the noise and sound it makes. I know you can get a silent cap for it. It's very expensive, but I prefer it just the way it is. Well, this is my camera. And it's the best camera out there, absolutely fantastic camera, brilliant. I've got the 50mm kit lens, so it's a fast lens, f1.8. It's a cheap camera. The reason why I say it's the best camera out there, because it's the only stills camera I've got. I can take stills with the camera that I'm filming on, which is a Lumix G7. I'll take a picture of it so you can see it. Yeah, you'll be able to see that. Bokeh, what they call bokeh, blurred background, because it's a fast lens. Very shallow depth of field. Why is it the best camera? As I said, I think, because it's the only one I've got. I do have plans on upgrading my photography and videography and for filming purposes and that, because the cameras are getting old now. The camera that I'm filming on at the moment has a few glitches. It's an old camera, it's not weather sealed, and I think over the years that the water and the weather has got into it, and it's beginning to sort of cause it a few issues. So I'm hoping to upgrade some of my equipment. New cameras of course really do cost an arm and a leg if you want something really nice. But having said that, with the little Nikon here, or rather big Nikon, it is the D3200, and with a bit of tweaking and choosing your shots you can get some nice pictures with it. So that's my camera that I use for most of my stills. I use this for taking all the pictures of my knives as well. On the top here is a wireless remote. As I say, this is a very cheap camera. I've had it for years. I really need to upgrade it, but it's the best one I've got. As they say, the camera you have with you is the best camera. Ooh, nice light.
Well, I scratched that itch, I got out, took a few snaps, had some fun, and made the best of the moment. We don't often get snow down in this part of the country, so really I just had to get out and make the most of it. And I don't regret it one little bit. It's making memories. Thanks for watching.